Hi, I'm Sudeep Chatterjee. What is this? So used to being on the other side of the camera. It's so weird. Hi, I'm Sudeep Chatterjee. I'm a cinematographer. Oh, what I love. I love the fact that this is my hobby. And I actually go out and practice my hobby and somebody pays me for it. It's, I don't believe actually people pay me for it. Ye to main aise hi karta. And yehi to karna. It's like I somehow find it unbelievable. Bachpan mein padhai karne bolte the log, and used to quietly, you know, in between the maths copy I would sketch something, and you know, I was so fond of visuals, and this is what I'm doing. What I love about my job is I get to travel not only to places, but also when you travel on an outdoor shoot, you go and mix with a crew from another country, from another place, and you kind of and a film set also brings people way together. So you also get to know people in such an intimate way, and you make friends with each film that you do. I have a new set of friends, and I genuinely count success with the amount of friends that you have. In our community of cinematographers, we are very competitive, but that competition is in a delightfully healthy way. That when I see a colleague doing a fabulous work, we don't react to it negatively, saying that, you know, that, oh shit, why did he shoot this film so well? I wish he hadn't. Like, so aisa nahi hota hai, but the competition is that you get inspired, and you say, "Acha, tune kaisa kiya? Main karke dikhata hu abhi. Let me show you." There are these senior DOPs whose work was at a time that I was breaking in, and they were like starting off my career. They were like works of Vinod Pradhan and Anil Mehta and Santosh Shivan and Ravi K. Chandran, Ashok Mehta. They were setting standards for us and inspiring us with their work. I really like Rodrigo Prieto's work. I really like Roger Dickens' work. Everyone does. Vittorio Storaro, Sven Nykvist. There's a lot of things. You can like, sometimes you've committed a certain time that you'll finish the shot in. And you said, okay, I'll be ready in 10 minutes, and you're not ready in 10 minutes. And then now you have to make a fool of everybody else. And you have to, you know, come out with stuff of distracting everybody, and, you know, and make sure that they don't catch you at your game. You can go to the loo and not come out while you've instructed your assistants to do something. Or you can find a fault in somebody's makeup and you can send them back and you can buy some time. There are lots of things. You can make a face and go to the director and say that, I don't, you know, I think the scene is wrong, and you know, you need to do something about the scene. And like, but I can't tell you all these things. It will be disastrous for my career if I let all the secrets out. Yeah. I would tell them to pick up a still camera and take still pictures on films where they are given a limited number of shots. And today, the biggest problem with the digital camera is that there's unlimited amount of stuff that you can shoot. You can always delete and shoot it again. That is, although it's great, but what it has done is it has taken away a little bit of thought that you put behind every frame. Ek frame ka ek sanctity hota hai. I was a kid and I was taking pictures, and I used to save little pocket money and buy films, and it was very precious. You only got those 36 shots. And so each time you take a picture, you wonder whether this is the best way to look at it or not. You move a little bit, or, you know, suddenly this is not good enough. You know, that there's a certain amount of thought that goes behind a frame. That is something I would want to advise him, that, you know, that put that thought. If you want to keep cinema alive, you'll have to bring people back into the theatre. And there's some responsibility to that. That the image has to look exciting enough for you to say that, no, I know it's going to come on the streaming channels in a month or so, yet I will go on to the theatre, buy a ticket and watch it with a whole lot of other people on the big screen. There's a film by Ray called Oparajito, which I think is fantastic. That's something I keep watching over and over again. It's a film about a mother and son, and the way Ray uses imagery to and pure cinematic language to bring the relationship and the two worlds so beautifully, metaphorically brought. Opu was shifted to Kolkata, and that's another landscape, and the mother stays in the village. Like, for instance, there's one sequence where Opu's he's living in Kolkata and he's studying in Kolkata, and he comes to visit his mother once in a while, and mother has asked him to, and he's asked his mother to wake him up in the morning, And the mother hasn't actually woken him up because some part of her doesn't want him to go away. So he's actually cheated and not woken him up. So when Oppu wakes up, he creates a ruckus. He realizes it's late and he might miss the train. And he creates a ruckus. He really misbehaves with his mother and darts out of the house without eating anything. And there, you have the, after this, you have the sequence where Oppu is sitting in the station and he decides not to take the train. He feels guilty about misbehaving with the mother, and he feels that, okay, he probably thinks that if he stays another day, it may not harm him that much. So he decides to stay back. There are just visuals of the station, the train coming in, the close-up of the bell going, and how he uses the bell to depict his state of mind. And then you have a shot of Shorboja just watching his son come back, and he says, "What happened?" And he very casually says that, "Nothing, I just missed the train. I was late, I missed the train." It's a very beautiful, very subtle emotion, but the way visuals are used in that, it's just something to learn from. I hope you guys had fun. It was nice talking to you. If you like it, please subscribe to Film Companion.